Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision's lab series on current sense amplifiers. My name is Peter Elia, and I'm an applications engineer in the current and position sensing product line. In this video, we will introduce gain error in current sense amplifier circuits. Total gain error includes the device's internal gain error, the device's gain drift with temperature, and device linearity. Technically, the shunt resistor tolerance also contributes to the system gain error, but this video will only focus on the device's gain error. Gain error differs from offset error in that it contributes the same amount of percentage error to the total system error over the linear dynamic range. In general, gain error is the dominant error type at high input signal levels. For the typical current sense amplifier, or abbreviated as CSA, device gain is set by the ratio of the internal network resistors RF and RNT. These resistors are not trimmed to an exact resistance. Rather, they are manufactured to have a precise ratio, as the ratio is what sets the device gain. How much the ratio varies is what dictates device gain error. Gain curves can be visualized with the plot on the right. Gain is simply the slope of the output versus the input. The worst-case maximum and minimum gain curves set the bounds of possible linear gain error in the current sense amplifier. Note that this plot assumes perfect linearity. Linearity error is a specification of how linear the gain curve is. To characterize linearity, the device's input is swept with n number of data points. A calibrated gain curve is calculated by linear approximation using two data points at 10% and 90% of the full-scale output range. For example, if the supply is 5 volts, the two points considered are 0.5 volts and 4.5 volts. Determining the calibrated gain requires calculating linear slope and offset. Linearity error, specified in the datasheet, is set by the data point that is the furthest from the calibrated gain curve. The percentage linearity error is calculated as Vout measured minus Vout calibrated divided by the full-scale Vout range. Usually, linearity error is much smaller than the maximum gain error and can be ignored. However, linearity error becomes more important if a system is to execute this two-point gain calibration. If the exact gain is determined for a CSA in a real system by measuring two data points and calculating linear gain, then the only remaining error left is the linearity error and gain drift. It is important to understand that the gain error specification of a CSA only applies when the device is operating within the testing conditions of the datasheet. Once the ambient temperature deviates from the gain error testing condition, the engineer must account for gain drift. For example, what is the maximum gain error if the system ambient temperature could vary from negative 10 degrees to positive 100 degrees Celsius? Well, the total gain error sums the initial gain error and the gain drift error. Initial gain error, which is tested at 25 degrees Celsius, is 0.2% max. When determining the drift component, the engineer needs to locate the drift specification and then multiply by the temperature change with respect to the initial gain error's testing temperature condition. The temperature change of importance is 100 degrees minus 25 degrees Celsius. Only the largest absolute change from 25 degrees Celsius should be considered, because the gain error specification can almost always be positive or negative. Note that an easy way to convert parts per million into percentage is to multiply by 10 to the negative 4th power. So, if we continue with the calculation in terms of percent, the maximum gain error is plus or minus 0.2275%. The worst case gains of a CSA are the maximum and minimum possible gains. To calculate these worst case gains, simply add all of the gain error percentages together and then divide by 100 to yield a gain error factor. Finally, add or subtract this gain error factor from 1. Since most all gain error specifications are symmetrical about 0, the maximum and minimum gains are symmetrical about the nominal device gain. It is important to know when gain error is reliable. Like most amplifiers, the output of CSAs are limited by their voltage supplies, and that they can only swing so close to the supply rails. How close the output can swing is set by specifications called swing to negative, VSN, otherwise known as swing to ground, and swing to positive rail, VSP. While the swing to rail specifications set the bounds of the output, they do not set the linear region of the amplifier. For proper amplifier gain, the output must be within the linear region. The range of the linear region depends upon several factors, but the best practice is to not violate the Vout versus Iout curves of the datasheet and apportion the linear output range to be tens to hundreds of millivolts within the swing to rail specifications. Gain error is always tested in a region smaller than the entire possible linear region, so it is helpful to understand how to set an appropriate output linear region and maximize an accurate dynamic range of the amplifier. Let's examine the INA210 as an example for determining linear output region. We will assume a 5-volt supply and a 2.5-volt reference voltage. If we examine the datasheet's electrical characteristics table, we can fill in the chart. For the swing to rail specifications, we see 50 millivolts for the swing to ground and VS minus 200 millivolts for the swing to positive rail, which translates to a 4.8 volt Vout limit for the 5-volt supply rail. Next, we see that the gain error is specified for an input range of negative 5 millivolts to positive 5 millivolts over temperature. Since the INA210 has a gain of 200 volts per volt and is offset with a 2.5 volt reference, this means that the gain error is tested from 1.5 volts to 3.5 volts. Remember that Vout always equals Vref plus Vin times G. Next, it's time to set an appropriate linear region. As long as we do not violate any output current conditions, we can conservatively set the linear region to be 50 millivolts below VSP and 50 millivolts above VSN. This equates to 100 millivolts to 4.75 volts of Vout range, which when referred to the input is negative 12 millivolts to positive 11.25 millivolts of sense voltage. Let's now consider an example using the INA210, which is set to a gain of 200 volts per volt with a plus or minus 1% maximum gain error. The available power supply is a 5-volt rail. The input voltage range of consideration, which is set by the load current and shunt resistor, will range from 500 microvolts to 22.5 millivolts. To calculate Vout ideal, we simply multiply the input voltage by the gain. This results in a range of 100 millivolts to 4.5 volts, which is well within the normal operating output region. The maximum and minimum possible output voltage equations are shown. When determining worst case error, it is best to pair a positive gain with a positive offset, and vice versa, a negative gain with a negative offset. The plot on the left shows the output error in volts between the actual and ideal outputs. In this case, you can see that the error voltage changes linearly with input voltage. The relative errors are plotted on the right. As stated earlier, relative gain error is constant over the input range. The total error curve includes the offset error, so error increases with a 1 over x relationship. We recommend selecting an amplifier with a gain error specification that meets or exceeds your total error requirement. Let's now consider an example using the INA226, which is a digital current sense monitor that converts the shunt voltage into digital codes. Determining gain error for digital CSAs uses the same theory, but the math changes since the input voltage is not amplified, but rather converted into the digital realm. For calculations, the gain is simply the inverse of the shunt voltage least significant bit. Since gain error is the same over the entire range, we can multiply the ideal shunt voltage by the gain and the gain error factor to determine the maximum and minimum worst case codes. As we can see, the error response for the digital device is the same as the analog. Absolute error on the left increases linearly, relative gain error is constant, and total relative error, which includes offset, has an inverse relationship where the curve approaches gain error at higher shunt voltages. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of the content. For more information and videos on current sense amplifiers, please visit ti.com/currentsense.